Hello everybody, and welcome to Legendary Encounters, the Predator deck building game. You've seen the unboxing short of it, and we're gonna play this game right now for you. It takes a while, so grab the popcorn. And are you excited?
I'm really excited. Looks like it's a pretty fun game.
And we already played the alien, of course, so let's do this.
We know what to do. Yeah.
Predator. First off, we have to fill up the HQ with cards. Because we can buy these cards for our decks, of course. I am a tracker, and you are?
A radio man.
Yeah. All right, we'll try to guide you through at least a little bit how to play this game. Because we both have our starter decks right here. It's always the same, and you can buy your cards over here to add to your deck. And that way it is a deck building game. That way you create your own deck. Well, our objective is right here, and this is the first Predator movie. So this is our objective, and this is what we're going to do for now. And then we have two and three as well, but first start off with one, of course.
Okay.
First off, you shuffle your deck and draw six. That's the first step. And with the cards in your hand, you're gonna buy things or defeat enemies right here. And the start of your turn is, you can see it here, well, not on camera, but you can read it. You start with the enemy and prey phase, and that means to put one of the enemies right here, face down, so we don't know what it is. That is the enemies that we have to fight. Those are the enemies that we have to fight. And before we can fight it, we have to know what it is, and you can do that by scanning. And it says here how many red you need. We call it red, but it is, yeah, that brute strength it is called in this game. These give red to your, well, how do you say it? To your mana pool, sort of. And then you can spend those red to fight or buy. That's basically it in a really short explanation. We'll just play and then you can see how it works. And then, hopefully we can explain more on the way. Another last thing to say is that these are our life points. I got 10.
I've got 11.
And if that drops to zero or less, we're dead, obviously. So I already started the turn with putting an enemy right there. And now I can see what we have here to buy. Right. I have three... Well, white to say, or stars. You can see over here, I got three of these cards. And that is your mana to say, let's just keep it in magic terms a little bit, to buy the cards that are over here. And since we're playing cooperatively, I can just show you that I have these cards. Nice, huh?
Yeah, nice.
So I
three
just,
of them.
Three, and then I can buy either this one or that one, or, let's put that up for to say, you can always buy a commander, and that gives you stars as well, or white. It's just called white and red. But I do have to read these cards because these cards are all new to us. Oh nice, this card heals strikes. That will be important later. And this one has coordinate, and I like that. Once this turn, you may avoid any one strike. When shit hits the fan and all the enemies are coming in the combat zone, you can get strikes and die like that, but these cards prevent you from getting strikes. So I'll just buy this one. Sure. This one goes to my graveyard. New card joins the fray. And let's see what else I have. I have one red, two red, and my special card, because I am the tracker, I get this card in my main deck. This gives me two red and has a special ability, which is not triggered right now, so I'm not gonna explain that yet. But it gives me two red, meaning that I can scan, and I will. So, scanning this, zzz, bam, and it is a Volverd Guerrilla, enemy human. On death, if the guerrilla camp is in the wilds, well, we don't have that yet. This is the wilds. Move it one space to the left. If it isn't in the wilds, draw a strike. Right. So that's a negative thing, anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And it costs three. Hopefully, you can see it. Three to defeat these guys. But that's okay. At least we know what it is. And
yeah, you can defeat them anywhere. Yep. Either in the wilds or in the combat zone.
Yes,
or preferably before they reach the combat zone.
Exactly. Well, that's my turn. I draw new cards. 6 again.
Yep.
Ta-da!
And the first step was put an enemy in the wilds, face down again. So this one pushes this one towards the combat zone.
Until it reaches.
Yes. And then it's gonna be dangerous for us.
Okay.
So it's your turn now.
It's my turn now. I only have 2 mana, which is not a lot. I can't even buy a commander.
I think we should. I think we should name it stars or something, because mana is maybe a little bit.
Well, let's just call them stars.
Stars, stars and stripes.
I'll have to read this.
That's okay.
Okay, this one heals strikes, which might come in handy, and it's the only card I can buy right now, so I'll just take it.
Let's do this. New card joins the fray again. It's one of 3 stars. That's buyable.
Okay.
Can you do anything else?
I can, actually. I have 4 attack power.
You know what? Wait a little bit right there. Yes?
Yeah, okay, I should hold it more like this. I've got 4 attack power and a card which I'm not gonna explain yet. It will come eventually. I can either scan a room or defeat an enemy, but...
The scan costs 4 and you can defeat the guerrillas, but on death, it says here, there is no guerrilla camp yet, so you get a strike if you kill it.
If it's in the wilds.
Yeah, and
so
it is.
So it's better not to kill it.
I don't know. Is it?
I'll draw.
Is it?
I'll just scan the room.
Yeah. Oh, it's the same one.
Oh.
Alright. So we have to find a guerrilla camp.
And I'll put this in my discard pile and draw 6 new cards.
Well. So we begin again with the same phase. A new enemy joins the wilds, because we're both in the wilds, of course. We don't know what it is yet, but we do know that we have 2 guerrillas to fight. So while my hand is not that big a deal, I just have 3 of each. So I think I'll start to kill one of these guerrillas, because that's cool. That means I use my brute strength to kill, that's very many, the first one. And I do have to draw a strike for that. Dead enemies. Striking means that I have to draw from the strike pile. I don't know what I draw. It could be very dangerous. It could be nothing. So here we go. Oh snap. We draw we draw this amazing art, by the way, but we draw this card, which says I have 1 wound, and it says, oh, this is the card that I was talking about. When you die, kill each other player.
Wow. Okay.
But it has only 1, so.
Yeah, we might be able to heal it,
yes.
Because I just bought this card, which can heal any strike.
Super awesome. I just put this next to my avatar and remind me that I have to be alive. Just put it like this. Here we go. All right, that was the first step. I can still buy with my 3. And what was this again? Enemies in the combat zone have -1 stripes or claw red.
Let's just call it attack power.
Attack, yes. I don't know. I think it's okay. This is a good time to check your graveyard, because I do know that I have my special card right here. Oh no, wait! It doesn't matter, because that's a different ability. Screw it! I'm just gonna buy this card. Knock knock. It gives me 2 red when I play it, and it has that extra ability that it lowers the enemies. So that's good.
So much. That means another card will enter the barracks.
Oof. Awesome art. And I draw a new card. I only have 1 in my deck, so that means I can shuffle.
And draw the remaining 5
And draw
cards.
The remaining 5, yes.
Yeah.
You can start with adding another hidden enemy.
Okay.
It always starts really slow, this game, but it could turn any minute.
Mm-hmm. Well, really nasty.
At least in the alien version, but okay. I don't know how much...
So. I've got 4 stars. Well, let's have a look. There's two cards on the board that I can buy. I'll have to read both of them. This one says choose a player, then that player draws two cards and discards two cards. Might become.
That's actually pretty nice.
Yeah. And the other one says once this turn you may switch an enemy or hidden card with a different enemy or hidden card.
You can switch a rule around here. That's maybe useful.
Yeah, I think I'll take this one.
Okay.
I'll just pay for it.
And a new card. Oh, it's the same one. It does have a little bit of glance over here, I see, but that's okay.
A little blip.
Whatever. We'll show you when we buy it.
Yeah. And I've got two attack power remaining.
I can't do anything with really that. I don't have a card with coordinate, which lets me join forces, really. I can give my card to him for this one turn, or actually copy it, that's more like it, and then he can use it, but I don't have that yet, so I guess you're done, right?
Yeah, I'll pass the turn, draw this one, and then...
Now,
shuffling.
We are playing with just the two of us, and I do know for a fact that this game is a lot more fun when you're playing it with four or even five players.
Well, that's a nice thing to say.
Yeah, but you do know, right? But yeah, we just wanted to try it out. This is our first playthrough of this game, and I did read some cards, but I haven't played it yet. So this is really exciting, really. All right, let's see what I have in my hand. I have a lot of red, I see, but let's start with... Where was that card with... that's four. I can't buy that yet. So I think I'll start with scanning and everything. I'll start with my Knock Knock card. I just bought this card, of course, and it's in my deck now, so I can use it. It gives me two red, and the enemies have minus one attack power, or health, to say. So I have two over here, so I could kill this one, or I can scan. I'm actually quite afraid to get another strike, because I already have one. It's only the beginning, I know, but I don't know. I think it's useful.
Quite a nasty one as well.
Yeah, exactly. I'll first add the other two. The call for backup ability isn't triggered. It's that's all about coordinating with each other. At least you don't have any coordinate, right?
Not yet.
So I have four. So I'll scan the river for three, meaning that I have one left, and it's another gorilla.
Mm.
Well, which has one minus.
I think this forest might be infested.
The forest is infested. Well, I'll just add another one, meaning that I have two, and I will kill another one because else we're getting overrun by gorillas. So I'll kill this, and I'll draw another strike, but that's fine. Ooh, oh god. It's cover me. It gives me a four, which is not good, but it has something extra. The other players may discard cards with a printed total of at least four red, or attack power, to cancel this strike.
Ooh.
So you could discard worth of four. Do you have that?
No, actually I don't. I have five stars and just one attack power.
So this just goes towards my strike.
Yep.
And I got five wounds already. Holy balls. I need that heal card of you.
And actually when you get this strike and you're playing not cooperatively like we're doing now,
yeah,
I could just tell a lie and say, okay, I don't have attack power.
For example.
Just to... Yes.
Depending on how we play, because I know you can play this with like as we do now, but you do have a competitive mode where you gather honor as the predator. But I don't know if you can actually need... If you need to lie there, because you don't really need to kill each other. It's more like gather all the praise instead of killing each other.
Okay.
But if you join with Alien, if you combine the two, then it's a different story. Because there, then... Oh, I can't even explain. That's too awesome.
Another time, maybe.
Another time, yes. I do have three left, and I will buy a Commander, I think. Because coordinate is really important, I believe. Because that's the ability to let other people copy this card in their turn. So that's mine now. Then I draw six and it's your turn again.
Okay.
Add the enemies.
So, as you might remember, I had 5 stars, so...
First is?
I can buy something...
Something good, 5. Right?
Yeah. I think this Brothers in Arm...
Brothers in Arm was when you play different character name cards.
Yeah. So this one is called Dylan, it says here on the on the top.
Yeah, let me show you.
If I play one of the other type of cards, then...
Yeah, we have Dutch, Mac, and another one, Blaine.
Yeah, I think I'll buy this.
All right, go ahead. And we have something. Pushing pencils. Okay.
I only have 1 attack power left, so
that's useless.
That's useless.
I think we're gonna get a hit soon.
Yeah.
All right, this goes up again. We didn't even find 1 predator, luckily, because I have a feeling that those cards will be insane. And I totally forgot that I had a coordinate card, but it didn't really matter because you couldn't scan anything.
We couldn't kill anything, couldn't scan anything.
So now it's to me again. This gives me 4 red, and I think I will use my normal red cards, the brute strength, to scan first this one. And it's a hazard.
Ooh,
hazards are linked with this one, right? Or this one?
No, with this one.
Oh yeah. And can you read that for me? What it does?
Yeah, it actually says, put a hazard card beneath your avatar as a mark. For each mark you have, put the leftmost enemy or hidden card in the wilds into the combat zone.
Oh, so the gorilla dudes instantly go to the...
Yeah, to the combat zone.
Okay.
Which places it here.
Correctly. Well, it does give a free space though. So, could be useful, I guess. Maybe? A little bit? Well, okay, so this card will strike me. And I don't have enough red left. Because I just spent it, of course. So this will be a problem. And I have 2 white, 2 stars. So I can't buy anything. So this turn for me is actually quite bad. You don't have any coordinators still, right?
Not yet, no.
So I just say finish my buying sequence. And this card strikes me again. And it's a deep gash. Well, not suitable for miners, but deep gash gives me 2 wounds extra. I'm at 7 already.
Wow.
Well.
That's a lot. Okay.
Exactly. I'll draw my new hand and don't forget to add an enemy. Maybe you can kill it though.
I can, actually.
Maybe I can have a coordinate for you. Alright, let's see what we got. I don't have any coordinate, so...
It doesn't really matter, I can kill it. And actually scan something else. Oh. Because I have 6 attack power in total.
Which card says that it works? Which card does that? Oh, you can scan and kill, you mean? Yes, nice.
I'm gonna spend 3 to kill this one. So it goes to
that. Yep.
That enemy spell.
And what does that card
do? I'm gonna use another 3 to scan this room.
Here we go. It's an event.
It's an event.
The events are listed right here. This card goes away after that. And what does the event do?
It says, better equipped every day.
Okay.
if the gorilla camp is in the wilds, move it 1 space to the right.
No. And that's it?
Just killed it. That's it.
Oh.
Yeah.
So it's an easy event. Normally the events are pretty harsh.
Yeah.
But okay, well, cool.
Okay. Well, I've got 3 mana left, so...
What did that sexy Tyrannosaurus...
this card, this name, oh my god.
He actually says that in the movie.
Yeah, it does.
And he's eating that, how'd you call that in English? I don't know, tobacco thing?
Yeah, chewing tobacco.
Yeah, chewing tobacco. It's really nasty.
Oh, bleh. I think
we should buy some
little some. I think I'll my commander.
I do have a call for backup card, so when you coordinate with me, I get extras, so that's good. Alright.
Alright. Pass turn.
Pass turn. This goes up again. Well, we haven't finished objective one yet, but it's going terrible. Because I'm already dead, almost. Let's see what we have here. I got a not so interesting hand. I have 5 stars, meaning that I can buy something nice, I guess. This is the draw and discard thing, but this only applies when you already play one of these blue icon cards, if you can see it. Meaning that it won't do anything unless I have other blue ones, but off the top of my head, I don't know if I have those. So maybe it's not the best choice to buy. But this one also has that, so... But with another symbol. What do you think? This one? It does discard and draws if it happens.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's the right choice. I'll buy this one anyway.
Yeah.
For 4.
You might be able to buy this one as well.
Yeah, maybe. That's 4 gone, and I have 1 red and 1 star. So, it's done for me.
Wow. You're not much help, are you?
No, I know. I'm like shooting in the wilds, but that's it. Missing everything.
Like the movie. Oh,
but now it's gonna get interesting because I have coordinate
for you. Man.
It is the commander that I bought, and I just noticed it has that blue symbol. I didn't even notice that. Whoa. So that's good.
That's
so if
really
you want,
good.
You can have 2 extra stars.
Yes, I would like.
Yeah?
Well, yes.
So I just say coordinate. There you go. This goes out of the game for now and goes to my graveyard when he's done with his turn and I draw a new card.
And I'll buy this one. It says kill a card in your hand if you played...
Kill.
That symbol before, I'm not sure which one it is.
Is that the machete?
Yeah, that's the machete.
Yeah, right. Every card has that.
Oh.
And killing a card means that you remove it from your deck and put it in the dead characters, meaning that you won't draw it again. So you can get rid of the boring brute strength, for example, because you rather have the cards that you bought, of course. And we have another sexual Tyrannosaurus. Yeah. You have to buy those, man. Are you gonna do anything else? I hope so, because else we get.
Yeah. Wait a minute. A call for backup was that you.
If I coordinated with you.
Okay, so I do actually have a call for backup.
I think if we talk strictly, you have to play this before I coordinated with you, but it doesn't really matter. Doesn't matter.
Okay, I thought it was the other way around, but
it doesn't matter. We do it anyway.
Yeah.
So what does it do?
It says a call for backup. If you coordinated with me once this turn, you may put a card from your discard pile on top of your deck.
Do you want to do that?
I could put this one on top of my deck.
And it gives 2 red, right?
Yeah, it does. So
I think that's useful.
I'll do that.
It
also gives me 2 attack power.
Mm-hmm.
3, 4, 5.
Nice.
So I have 5 in total.
5 red.
5 red in total.
Mm-hmm.
So I think I'll just scan this room and see what turns up.
And you have 3 left. What the hell is that?
Each fat Verdi gorilla has +1. So
these guys.
Yeah. Those
but
guys that we destroyed earlier are becoming stronger.
Hmm.
So I have 3 left, so I think I'll just scan this room.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
and it's an event.
Another event.
That was this one, right? It didn't do anything.
You have to... No, not now.
Move the thing.
The Gruya camp, but
okay.
There's no Gruya camp.
Not yet.
Not yet.
So now we have a space open, meaning that this card won't go into the combat zone, which is good for me.
I'll pass the turn.
That means that I can draw 1 card for my coordinate action, and I continue the turn. So we add another card, which keeps filling up, right? But now I can kill dudes as well. Do you have coordinate? Because I have a call for backup card, this one, the one that is in my deck. You don't?
Nope.
useless piece of But I do have 5 red. What you say? Should I kill the big guy?
Or I think that if you could kill something, you should.
I think so too, because else it goes into the combat zone. Is there anything else that I can do? No. So I'll just do that. Kill this guy. The guerrilla lord. Advisor. It's not really a lord. And I have 2 white left, meaning that I could buy another sexual Tyrannosaurus, but I think you want this. You have this first one, right?
Yeah, I do.
Because this card triggers when you play another red symbol card. And I don't have that, because I was the one with the blue stuff. So I'll just leave that there for you. And don't do anything with my experience. Meaning that my turn has ended.
Okay.
Draw my new cards. And we add another enemy, of course. So I do have a lot of coordinate in my deck, so that could be nice. Let's see what I draw this turn.
I'm gonna use 2 to get another sexual Tyrannosaurus.
New card? Ooh. And I do have a coordinate card, by the way. It's the Real Nasty Habit card, which gives you 1.
Ah!
And you can avoid the next strike. Would you like to have that? To scan and kill?
Sure, why not? It gives me a total of 5 to spend on attack.
And if you if you get any strike one way or another, you have
I'll just
to
kind of flip over.
Yeah, this one ruined.
This one, yeah, sure. There's no system to me flipping over cards, by the way. I'll just whack it. I'll take the strike.
Kill it.
Gives us some room to breathe.
See what we have.
Ah, that's nice.
Another deep gash.
Just 1 damage.
Oh, is that not a deep gash?
No, it's a flesh wound.
Well, it doesn't seem like a flesh wound. Your whole face is gone.
No, it's more like a punch in the face.
Oh, really?
Yeah, really.
Oh, all right. Then it's different. Yes. Cool.
That's it. I don't have anything else.
Draw another card for the coordinate madness. Add a card to this. It's actually following steps, this game. And when you're playing the cooperative version, you just have to speak with each other for a difference. Okay. Do you have coordinate? Or don't you?
I actually do. Seriously? I've got stars, 2 of them.
Oh. Maybe that's useful, because then I can buy this big card.
Sure, yeah.
This has Brothers in Arms if you played a different character.
It also goes with
exactly.
Blue color.
That's why I wanted it. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and, 6, 7. So I have 1 left, and I buy this one. Yep. Flip! Oh, it's the same one as this one. And I have 1, 2, 3, and the combat zone dudes have 1 less health again.
Yeah.
Would you say the runes again? Maybe I can kill it if it's a low.
Sure.
If it's a low dude. Hup. Ah,
screw your cap.
Objective, goal. This has something to do with the goal and our objective. Would you read it? It's closer to you.
The objective is to locate and wipe out the guerrilla camp. So
okay,
it should say on there what we should do, I think.
On reveal, let me first show you the card before I can
reveal it.
Attach to the river, which is over here. Then move it 1 space to the right for each discarded event, which is 2. Ah, now now it's...
So it's going underground.
Underground. And it says, while it's in the wilds, while the space is clear, you may pay 1 red and wipe out the guerrilla camp, discard it, and complete the objective. Hold on a minute.
Aha. So we'll have to clear out the underground room and pay 1 to clear out the thing that comes after it.
Exactly. Put it here. And is there anything else?
But this is quite a difficult one to clear, because you have to pay 4 to scan the room.
Yeah.
And then you'll have to kill whatever is in it.
Mm-hmm.
That's quite difficult. That's going to be some task.
Yeah. Well, I don't have any red left, so that means that I'm done.
Okay. So remember, I coordinated with Villa, and which means I can draw one extra card. I'll have to shuffle my pile first.
Oh,
sure.
Is this what I did?
Okay.
This is what I.
You don't have anything to coordinate with me.
Yeah, I'm just checking.
It's a really important part of the game, so.
No, I think this is my hand. So no.
Okay.
No. Did you add a dude?
A dude, a dude. no, we oui,
oui, no, no, we oui, sui. Sui.
You've not done that. Okay.
Anyway.
Okay, so actually, I have brothers in arms on this card. It says it will give me 2 stars if I play another one. I've got Blaine, our sexual terrorist. I've got this one, which gives me 1 plus the 2 for the other one. Makes 5, 6 and 7 stars to spend, which is quite a lot.
And this is not triggered, right? Not yet.
Oh, the, what is not triggered?
No, the heal. The heal ability.
No.
It's about. It's about. Wish I had some more coordinate.
And so that gives me 7 in total. I think I'll take this one because it has a good synergy with my other cards. Mm-hmm. It's red also. Mm-hmm. And it's this character that I haven't got yet. And I'll think.
Well, let's put a new one here. Yeah. Oh, another sexual Tyrannosaurus. Buy it. Then you have 3 in your deck. You can heal anything.
I can heal anything.
That's good.
I'll take this one.
Yeah. Another one?
Oh, no.
It's a bad idea.
Oh, so I have 2 left, but I think I'll keep it to this. I've got 3 attack power.
Scan.
I'm going to spend 2 scan.
That one is
this room.
Whoa.
One at a time. When it's in a combat zone, when any player draws a close call, they draw another strike.
So a close call card is a card that does nothing when you draw it, so you don't get any wounds, but this card prevents that.
Probably.
Hmm. And it does have 7 cost to defeat. So that's a lot.
Yeah. We'll have to get rid of that.
And of course that's the hand of the predator, so it's coming together. You're done, right?
Yeah, I'm done.
So, first of all, a new enemy joins the wilds, meaning that the leftmost will be put in
holy balls
in the combat zone. It has oh dear. Oh wait, that's okay. We revealed this card. It has double strike, meaning that you have to draw 2 strike cards.
Ouch.
Yeah, and it has. When it's in the combat zone, which it is, at the end of the strike phase, discard this enemy. So it's only a one-time double strike. Well, let's see.
Well, this could be quite fatal to you.
Yeah, so I think I'm gonna...
Since you're already at 7 damage.
Do you have any coordinate? Because I have a call for backup.
Yeah, I do, actually.
I do that, so I can scan for free.
It's stars though, but it's still coordinated.
That's okay.
So it'll work.
Uh-huh. Well, I'll save those stars for later. And now I have the 2 red, and I can, once this turn, you may scan any space. So let's just see if I can complete the objective, maybe.
Yeah.
So I'll scan this for free. And it is an awesome predator card. It looks menacing. But it says, ongoing, this enemy has -2 health for each different class you've played this turn.
Okay.
And the classes are the red one, the chip, the fist. Meaning that it's already down 2, and your coordinate card, which is a chip dude.
Yep.
Meaning it's already 4 down, so it's not that hard to kill. Meanwhile, I joined this one, and this one has 4 and 5.
Which is enough to kill this one, at least.
Yeah, but this one is easy to kill, I think.
Yeah.
Or I can agree. Complete the objective. That could be true, but I think I'll die. And when I die, you die.
You might. Yeah.
So I have to do this. I'll kill this guy.
Sure.
Meaning this is done.
It's too big a risk.
Too big a risk, yes. And I think you can kill this easily. And I have two left as nothing. So that was it, man.
Okay. That means this one will hit the combat zone. Oh, that's okay. It's an event.
Ooh, that did things.
No, it really doesn't. No, only if a guerrilla camp is in the wild.
It is.
Oh, I move it one space to red, but it's at the utmost red, so that's okay. Not a really a problem.
Yeah. No, that. Oh, yeah, right. You're right. Sorry. Sometimes it's quite difficult to remember which card was actually active or face down or anything. All right, let's see what I have. I do have coordinate for stars.
Yeah.
Maybe you have call for backup.
I can draw another one because I coordinated with you. Let's see here. I've got 6 damage in total, which is nice.
And this one, if you have anything of all, you get. So maybe we can get 2 birds, 1 stone.
I've got chips.
I got I got the blue symbol, but that does mean that I can't do my other card, you know, with the discard and draw, but
no, that's okay.
I'd rather give it to you and try to kill this one as well.
I'll play the not call for backup.
This one too then?
With the stick around, so I'll get the bonus for
coordinating.
For coordinating and for coordinating, so I can put any card on top of my deck.
That's kind of haste in Magic terms.
I think I'll take the same kind of jungle because it'll allow me to switch any enemy or hidden card with a different enemy or hidden card. So I might be able to switch this one with this one. This one is easier killed, and
or maybe
be able to complete the objective
or get away with this big ass thing.
Yeah.
So
prevent it from coming into the combat zone.
Oh, we're so good at this game.
So that actually makes 6 damage.
6 and 2 stars.
2 stars.
So this one is down 4.
It's down 4. So I can... Oh, well, I'll just kill this.
Yeah.
I think.
Yeah, sure. Bonk.
And I can scan this room. Doesn't really right? matter, but we'll know what's coming. I've got 2 left.
So. Oh, yeah, 2 left, of course. Yeah, you can't do anything else. Scan.
Ah, it's an event.
This one moves, but doesn't matter.
So I've got 4 mana left. 4 no, stars. 6.
6 because of my coordinator.
Yeah, but this.
Oh,
this is only 2. So I've got 4 left.
Yes, then. Yes. Yes. You did have a lot of chip work going on.
Yep, but I'll rather have this one, I think.
Yeah, then you can look, and if you want, you can scan it, but you don't have to. So if it's something terrible, you can choose not to scan while knowing what it is.
Well, that's pretty okay. I'll take this one. Yeah, sure.
Oh no, I thought it was the sexual Tyrannosaurus. Damn it! Alright. This is what I want, I think.
That concludes my turn. That one moves.
This one goes up. And I draw an extra card because of the coordinating. And maybe you have something coordinating.
No, I don't.
Useless. I do have a lot of white this turn, so I think it will be just that. 6. And I think I buy that other sixer, this one, because that has that blue symbol again. Or, no wait. I buy this one. Because I can coordinate this with my friend, and he gets to trigger his red cards, his sexual Tyrannosaurus cards, because this is a red card, meaning that I can help him trigger stuff. I buy this for 3.
Trigomania.
3 left. Is it a sexual
No, sadly no.
I have another 3, but I don't really know if I want this. Well, it's killing, right? So it's actually pretty good. I'll buy it anyway. Why not? It's another one of these. And I have 1 red, useless in this case. I'm done.
Okay.
Well, I do have to say we have had a little bit of luck with the events, because in the alien version, events had a far more severe consequences than just nothing really, because you had to add cards here or move to the combat zone or get extra cards that can kill you instantly. So, but maybe it is quite difficult if this shifts every single turn. Maybe I can understand why it could be annoying.
This is a really difficult one. It doesn't leave me with much. I've got 3 attack power and 5 stars. I don't know.
I don't have any coordinate. No. I do have a lot of red for the next turn, though.
I think I'll buy same kind of jungle.
Okay.
Just because of the switcheroo abilities.
Right. For clear
all purposes. Switcheroo.
Ooh, this is a big card. This is one of the rare cards in the character decks. It costs 8, as you can see. That's a lot of stars. It has coordinate, and it says, this is really cool, you can't die until the end of your next turn.
Oh, that's
but it does cost a lot, 8. So, and it gives you 4, of course. That concludes your turn?
No, actually it doesn't. I have 3 attack power to spend, so I'm
gonna didn't you just buy this one?
Yeah, but I put it on top. No?
Yep. Oh, yeah, right, of course.
I've got 2 of them.
He's got 2, of course. Boom bots.
I'll just scan this room then.
What is it? It is an enemy.
At the start of the strike phase on your turn, if you are marked.
Which you are not, because you didn't have the hazard.
Yep.
I am.
This enemy strikes.
Oh, damn it. So even though it is in the wilds, which normally doesn't strike you, this card still strikes you because it's the shoulder cannon of the predator, which can shoot. Alright, so that's a problem. Ooh. I think I have to kill that.
Okay.
So meaning that this card will go to the...
To the combat zone.
Yeah. So slightly. Close calls are definitely useless now. Doesn't matter. Let's see. Well, I still have the chance to buy and kill. I hope you have coordinate, because that would really help me. Oh, no, wait.
This will also strike you this turn.
If I kill it, then it won't.
True enough.
Because I have the Brothers in Arms, meaning that if I play other character cards, I get bonus.
I might be able to help you with coordinate. Exactly.
And I have this one too with Call for Backup. So... see what I can kill. I do have 2 red at least, plus 2, plus potential your coordinate thing.
I don't think I have any attack power and coordinate. Maybe
no, but
plus
I do.
1.
Right, but that doesn't really matter, I think. Now I just figured something out actually, because this is not a character card, it's a role card. So it does that.
I do have coordinates actually.
Okay. It says here that roll cards and commanders don't count towards Brothers in Arms, meaning that this card doesn't trigger my other card, which is actually not that good. But your coordinate card, or is that a commander as well? It is.
Yeah.
So this card isn't as powerful as it should be. Damn it. Meaning that I will be boned. So I'll just put it there, and I have 5, so I think I'll just kill that shoulder cannon. And would you like me to free scan something that works with the call for backup if you coordinate? I think it is worth something.
If I coordinate, sure, I'll coordinate.
This one is dead anyway. You coordinate, meaning that I can scan something for free. Let's just do this one. This is the furthest. Farthest?
Doesn't really matter.
Not really. Oh. Reveal in the wilds, draw a strike, then turn his enemy face down. Oh no! Oh, and this card...
You're getting close to
I'm getting so close to death. And if I die, you die.
Yeah.
We need a third player. So I'll just... Ooh!
Oh.
Okay, I thought I was dead. But it is a 5 wound, which would make me dead. But it says, another player may take this strike instead of you.
Oh, sure.
And it's
I'll take it.
It's called sacrifice. Oh my god.
Leaves me with 6 damage.
6 damage, so you're at 5 life.
Yeah, that's okay.
That's okay, okay.
We're still both alive.
This goes down again, because it said so. That's really nasty. That's the cloaking device, of course.
Yeah.
And I do have 2 white stars, meaning I could buy...
Plus my commander.
Yeah, two extra. Exactly. So 4. I'll buy this one, because killing cards, maybe we get something even better. And that concludes my turn. No, it doesn't, because I got a strike. So, here's
I still die.
It's a deep gash. I'm dead. I think I'm dead. 2 plus 2 plus 4 is 8. Oh no, wait, I'm at 1. I have 9 wounds now.
Wow.
So I'm barely hanging in there. So you have to get rid of this thing, man.
I'll try.
I'm done.
That means these will relocate.
So that's the thing about this game, for a note of feedback. If you play this on your own, you can play this on your own, or with just 2 or 3 players. It could be like this and really hard, because now I'm already dead. But yeah, on the other hand, it is kind of random, of course.
You're not already dead.
Not yet, but...
Close to.
I'm close to dead. I do have coordinate for you, by the way.
Ah, nice.
Which has a red symbol as well.
Ooh.
So, and that's, it's this one.
Ah. Well, that might change things a bit, because I have my sexual Tyrannosaurus, which allows me to heal any strike.
Finally, and you have 1 red.
Baby.
Mm-hmm. So what do you want to do? You want to remove that when I die, you die, or the 4?
Just the largest one, I think.
I think so too. So this goes to the discarded strikes, meaning that I recuperate.
We have some room to breathe.
Exactly. So you have 1 red, don't forget.
I've got 3 mana, and there's not really anything I want to buy.
No.
I'll just leave.
Maybe later.
Maybe later.
What if we see something here, maybe?
I have the call for backup cards, and I can put 1 card from my discard pile on
because
top. I'll just get the sexual Tyrannosaurus back on top.
Oh yeah, of course, now you can.
Yeah, I've got a deck.
That works.
Okay, I've got 6 damage in total, which is...
Do you want to try to complete it? Scan and...
Sure. Or just scan it.
It does cost 4 though, but... On reveal, each marked player reveals the top 3 cards of their deck. So that's me. Discards each with cost 1 or more and puts the rest back on top. So I revealed this, which is not too interesting.
Just 1 or more back.
So yeah, nothing really happens, but it is a 6 card. So.
Okay.
So you have 2 left.
I'll just scan this one.
Hey!
Defensive position.
Oh, it says objective 2. That's the thing for objective 2, so we have to hurry, man.
Reveal says move to operations, which is here. While the hills are clear.
Over here?
Yeah.
It's not.
The team may discard cards with a printed total of 6 stars from their hands to attach this to the hills and complete the objective. So
right,
we can actually work together on this.
But we first have to complete this still, so we do have to...
Yeah. So we have to clear the hills first.
Yeah. So this one goes over here and we'll just save it for later. Because we can't do that yet, since we're not completing objective 1 yet.
Yeah.
But we do have a free space. And that's good.
It is. That concludes my turn.
You have to draw a strike.
Oh! I thought you would forget.
Yeah.
What is it? It says X. At the start of your next turn, discard this and draw two strikes.
Oh, so you have some. But it doesn't. It doesn't give you wounds now. So that's something positive, at least. This one goes over here. We do have to hurry now, man. Seriously.
I know.
And I draw a card, of course, because I coordinated. I'll just start. Since we know a little bit more about the game. We have two, and the enemies have one less health for this turn. I play another card, which is triggered. You may kill a card in your hand, and I kill my experience card. Because that's not so not so useful. I'll just remove that from the game.
Any commander is better than that card.
Exactly, or anything. Together with these, make six. You don't have any coordinate, right?
I don't, no.
Too bad, because I was hoping to kill this big-ass coordinate.
Yeah.
Oh, enemies in the combat zone have minus one. Yeah. Oh, meaning it's six. So I will kill this card.
Kill it.
Bomb. I'm done instantly, but hey, it's killed.
Hey, and you can avoid the strikes.
Exactly,
well.
Exactly. Yeah. That's it.
Okay. Well, that leaves me with
a bit of
a problem.
Well, it's the cloaked predator card.
Oh, wait. I made a mistake. I'm sorry.
Why?
No, I didn't. No.
You're doing it perfectly.
I'm a perfect being. I don't know. Let's say it again.
I admire its purity, right? Oh no, wait, that's a different movie. So this card decreases when you play multiple classes, so that's...
So...
It's a little easier.
That leaves me... do you have coordinates?
No, I don't.
Oh, that's too bad, because I would be able to kill it otherwise.
Yeah.
I have two different symbols, so that leaves it up to four, and I only have three attack power.
Damn it.
I'll just...
What an uncoordinated business.
Ooh.
Oh, another one. Each marked player... Oh, that's me again.
Oh, and I... But I also have to draw two strikes.
We totally forgot about that.
Ooh.
What is it? Oh, dear God. I do not like the sound of that.
It's one for four damage.
Oh, that's this one, right?
Yeah, the other players may discard cards with a printed total of at least four attack power to cancel this strike.
Do you want me to do it? It does save you, and I need you. So I'll just sacrifice myself!
Otherwise I would be dead.
Yeah.
Yeah, really dead.
And that's the second one?
That's only flesh wounds, luckily.
Alright, so you're still alive. And
I'm at 7 damage right now.
This is what I had to do. What was it again? Look at the top 3 and discard all with 1 or more. Meaning that I have to discard these two. Discard isn't so bad as kill, but it's annoying. Alright.
Okay, so I've got 5 stars. Is there anything I want?
You could buy another chip. Or a coordinate card, maybe. It does give white, but you help me.
Those give white as well.
True.
So but I'll just get the coordinate.
Yeah.
Ah, it's a red one.
It's this a red one as well.
Pretty decent as a combination with my sexual tyrannosaurus. That's a really nice word.
Yeah.
Okay, your turn.
First the strike, man.
Oh no. What 2 damage, that leaves me at 1 life.
No, 2. You're at 9, and you're at 11 life, so 2.
Oh, yeah.
But it's still a lot, because my turn is going to be crap. Because I can't do nothing. And I even have
so
to...
So you can actually do something.
I can't actually do something. Sorry about that. I mean, I can't do it. I can't do this sentence. I can't play. I do not have anything in my hands. Because this card joins the fray as well.
I do not have any coordinates.
You don't even have coordinates, so I think this will be the end of this. Oh no, wait, of course not, because that big card was removed.
Oh, I do actually, I have 1 damage to coordinate.
Well, it's better than nothing. I can scan.
Yeah, okay.
Is it the, which one is it?
Yeah.
There are two dudes here. I don't know, man. I think drawing healing strikes would be nice. Oh, I can avoid a strike. That's good. Because I get your card.
Okay, yeah, or sure.
I play your card.
You get one. Yeah,
sure. Right, sure.
I'll coordinate it with you.
Well, that's a little bit scary. A little bit less scary. I put one extra. I'll scan. That's the only thing I can do.
Yep.
You son of a bitch. draw a strike, then turn this enemy face down. So.
Ah, that's the same one.
Yeah, of course. I totally forgot that that was that. Well, it doesn't matter though, because I can't avoid that. Because of your card, but so that's it, and I draw two strikes instead of three. So this is a flesh wound, which is good. And oh no! Wait, this is the mark. It is a one card, one wound, but it says draw another strike for each mark you have, and I have one. So I'll draw another one, and it is a deep gash. Am I not dead already? 2 + 1 = 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. No.
One life again.
This is exciting, man. Okay, I'm done.
Okay, I can draw another card.
I draw my hand, and I think I do have coordinate. Yes, I have the same card that I'll just show you instantly. It's the same card that you coordinated with me, so you can avoid a card, avoid a strike again. Super nice, and you have one.
Sure. Well, I have to.
Oh yeah. That too. No, that's easy.
Yeah, that's the easy part.
But we are in the shit, as you say that. This one is easy to kill, but because it doesn't do anything now.
Okay, so I can play... you coordinated with me, so I get an extra two stars.
Mm-hmm.
And this one has the... Oh, I don't know, I just call it the Hulk hand. I don't know what it is.
The fist. The green symbol.
And this one does something extra when you you played one of these before. So I can now actually switch a hidden card with another
plus
enemy.
Plus, you have to remind, you have green and red.
Yeah.
So these are now four both. So yeah, if you have anything else in your hand, we could maybe even decrease them to two each.
I actually don't, no.
You son of a bitch, no.
I'm sorry.
Fine. Go on with your plan, though.
I could switch this one with this one.
You mean this one, or this is one? We can complete the objective.
Yeah, that's what I meant. Obviously.
Alright, go ahead.
So,
which does mean that this card is flipped.
300 city blocks. This is one of the cards that has something to do with our objective.
Oh, really?
Review. Attach this card to the final enemy. If you can't add an enemy to the wilds, then shuffle this into the enemy deck.
Okay. That's really nasty.
This is from the last chapter.
Yeah, we're way behind. Normally we should have done this already. Yeah. But
so this should
so we have one.
Should we damn it.
Oh, that's why it's so nasty. That's why this game is really hard. And now
so
I know why
I actually can't complete this quest.
Mm-hmm. And now I know why it's so terrible that it's here, because it costs four every single time.
Yeah. And now I know why this one is so terrible.
So I have to shuffle the card back. Oh, that's so nasty.
Oh, I was
so
I
close.
I was able to oh man.
But you yeah.
Now we're completely at a loss.
Well, at least you can kill this one.
Well, yeah, sure. I'll smack netty this one. I've got two left, so I'll use that to scan this room.
No, you don't, you have four. 1, 2, 3, 4. And this one was just because of the switch.
Okay, and we...
I'd say
I'll kill one of these.
Last try. And you have still the avoidable strike, right? So you only get one strike.
Oh, that's...
So that's a little bit...
I think I'll be dead anyway.
I don't know. It could be a close call.
It could be.
Or it's something amazingly strong and then you're dead.
It should be at least...
Are you going to buy something with your three? Plus your hand.
Five.
I'd say just do it, man.
Just do it. I'll just take this one,
I think. Go ahead. Do it. And it's another knock-knock. All right, so... You avoid one strike.
Yep.
This one doesn't really matter, and you draw one. So, fingers crossed. Close call.
It's a flesh wound, which leaves me at one life.
Nine, I want two. Oh god.
Okay.
Well, there is one positive side of this. I can shuffle my deck. So there's a potential of getting.
Me too, and I can draw just one card from it because I have. Five other ones in my hand already.
It better be one of that healing cards or something.
Yeah.
Or maybe a coordinate card. But let's just shuffle this here. It's really terrible that we're stuck at one. But that's a perfect example of how this game could be, because we also had games that we went flying through it and it was really
with
easy.
Alien, yeah,
especially with only two players, but with. If you have more players, it's becoming a lot harder, in my opinion. And in the end, also a little bit easier because you have more influences. But yeah,
it does.
Draw. Let's see what I got. Did I get something good? No.
It's really much easier when you have two other people to coordinate with you.
Well, I hope you have something to coordinate because... I do not see.
I've got two sexual. Okay. Three sexual pterosauruses.
Is that coordinate though? Or
No, it isn't. But
okay.
I don't have anything to coordinate with. Well, I'm sorry.
Worst case scenario, I die and you die instantly because of me. And you cannot use your.
Okay, so there's also an upside to this. You're at one life, same as me.
Yeah.
So it doesn't really matter.
Oh no, yeah, you're dead anyway. We're both dead anyway. All right, let's see.
Well, actually, if I get a turn, I can actually heal two strikes.
Mm-hmm. And maybe even three if we have a lot of close calls. But all right, let's see what we do. I have this one gives me doesn't really matter. Gives me white. This one is red. Kills a card. That's good. Plus this one, it's only three. No. This one is down to four because I played two differently, but it's not enough to kill it. Shit. So, I think I'll just scan.
And then pass away.
And then pass away silently. But maybe it's something. Maybe it's something that. Does something or
I don't know. You should try anything.
I'll do this one on the river.
Sure.
Ha!
No, it's on death.
No, it's on death, and it's just a dude. Well, then I have four. Boy, this one doesn't really matter. Maybe it's no. And then now we go to the part where I die. I think. Actually, yeah. Oh yeah, I killed the card. So.
Two strikes.
Two cards. First one is three. And it says, when this strike is healed from you, draw a strike. That's nasty.
That's really nasty.
This is the card. It's a cut off hand, meaning that I'm already dead, but I'll just put the extra strike. It's just a flesh wound. So that means we're dead, man. We are being.
We're done.
We're sliced open by the predators. So much for the Predator deck building game. I hope you liked watching it. We tried to make it fast and we died horribly.
Yeah,
your head cut off and I was stabbed in the butt and everything.
Yeah, impaled in the butt.
Impaled, yeah, graphic content. But it is really awesome to play and you definitely have to try it if you have the chance. And we have to invite more people.
Yeah,
because we need backup with this.
A lot. At least two other people, I think.
At least, yes, I think so too. So thank you for watching. Leave a thumbs up, a comment if you want. Tell me if you like more other than Magic. Then maybe I can play the Alien version as well once. Maybe. Could be fun. see how different it is. And maybe in the end, when we combine the two, oh, so much potential. Anyway, until the next video. Laters!